I'm going to invite my friend Marcy Boyd from Berkeley to do the land acknowledgement this week. We're going to be doing land acknowledgements regularly, which is just something, it's a practice that many individuals and people are taking on to really make another step toward reweaving our relationship with the indigenous first dwellers of our country, of this country. And this is not a repair, it's just an acknowledgement. Repair would take much more, but it gets us thinking about how we can repair the damage and the loss and the robbery of native lands and peoples and ways of life. So this is our effort in that direction. So Marcy, please unmute and offer the acknowledgement.
We who live along the eastern shore of San Francisco Bay acknowledge that the land we are on is the traditional land of the Lushan Ohlone people. The Ohlone name for this area is Huchin. The West Berkeley Shell Mound is the site of the first village of the first people in the San Francisco Bay Area. It is a sacred burial land for the Ohlone Chokenyo, who lived here for thousands of years in harmony with nature. We honor those who were here before us and their descendants who are rightfully reclaiming their ancestral lands. We offer gratitude to the original stewards of this land and to the land itself.
So bringing all of the week behind us to this night and this moment, here's the opening invitation to lay it down, let it rest. Evening falls, the day is ending, all my work, I lay it down. Evening falls, the day is ending, all my work, I lay it down. Let it rest until tomorrow, day is done. Those of you that don't know it, maybe don't even have the words, we'll just do that part again. Evening falls, the day is ending, all my work, I lay it down. Let it rest until tomorrow, day is done, lay it down. Evening falls, the day is ending, all my work, I lay it down. Let it rest until tomorrow, day is done, lay it down, lay it down, your every burden, evening shadows gather round, come sweet night. And gentle darkness, day is done, lay it down. We'll do that again also. Really welcome everybody to just sing as your heart feels it, mumble along. Lay it down, your every burden, evening shadows gather. Come sweet night and gentle darkness, day is done, lay it down. One more time. Evening falls, the day is ending, all my work, I lay it down, let it rest. Let it rest until tomorrow, day is done, lay it down, your every burden, lay it down, your every burden, evening shadows, gather round, come sweet night. Gentle darkness, day is done. Lay it down. Come, sweet night. Come, sweet night, and gentle darkness. Day is done. So welcome, warm welcome, anybody who came in a little late. I'm so glad we're doing this. So I think I don't, it's no surprise to say, but I want to name the truth that we've had an extraordinary week. We've had terrible wildfires here in California. We've had another police shooting of an unarmed black man. And the natural people in the streets following up on that, and then the murder of two people by a white supremacist 17-year-old boy. And then, although I hope most of us are ignoring it as best we can, there is a national convention of the Republicans, and it is not something that we really honestly need to listen to. It's very disturbing, and we are about cultivating the resiliency and the heart capacity to bring our best to this time. That's what this is all about in my world. So I want to do another chant with you. We've done this before, and it's just a time. It evokes the heart. It's the way of the heart. Let the way of the heart shine through. Love upon love upon love. All hearts are beating as one. Love upon love, light, light upon light upon light, all disappear into one. So this we can just release ourselves into. It's a chant, it's got a strong rhythm, so just let it roll through you and carry you. Don't think about it too much. Really just go into your body, into your heartbeat, into the rhythm of the pulse and the heart and the lungs and the vibration, and let this heal you. Let the way of the heart, let the way of the heart, let the way of the heart shine through. Let the way of the heart, let the way of the heart, let the love upon love upon love. All hearts are beating as one. Light upon light upon light. All disappear into one. Let it go. Let the way of the heart, let the way of the heart shine through. Let the way of the heart, let the way of the heart, let the way of the heart shine through. Love upon love. Making rhythm with your body, put our whole beings into this. Let the way of the heart, let the way of the heart, let the way of the heart shine through. Let the way of the heart, let the way of the heart, let the way of the heart shine through. it yet, it'd be a great time to do that. I've got my lid behind me. You probably can't see it behind my guitar, but you'll see it later. And let's just take this ride into a little time of centering, breathing, and grounding to really give ourselves this moment to come home to a private place, what my friend Amy calls a still quiet place. It's a faithful friend. It's a place that is always, always available to us. And we'll just take a few deep breaths. Let your shoulders roll up and back and then fall gently back so you open your chest a little bit. Breathe through your nose and then exhale through your mouth and let it be a sigh. Just release and go way down. Let it go way down and then let it rest for a minute before you take your next breath. Just empty out. Know that you are breathing out and releasing tensions, worries, pain, confusion, despair, whatever's got you tied up at all, just breathe it out, let it go, lay it down. And then bring your awareness down into your lower belly, below your navel. You might even want to touch, lay your palm on that lower belly. Breathe all the way down and feel that whole belly open and stretch. Not with force, but just with a releasing and an expansion. This is our center of gravity. This is our grounding place. And with each breath, just gather in what is scattered, what is tugging at you, what is still hovering, and gather it all in and then release it down. Let it rest deep in the pool of that belly. Let all your tension release. And know that whatever you've been carrying is a measure of how much you care, how connected you are to the world and to those who are hurting right now. So we don't lay it down to do a spiritual bypass and kind of only look at the light and only think about the light. It's not that. It's just that we need to rest and trust that all of this is being held somehow in great mysterious forces of evolution, of billions of years of this planet, this galaxy, this universe unfolding in a remarkable way. And we're in a tiny dust mote of a moment here. And it is everything we know. And it is precious and vital, and it is gone in a moment. So we take our rest, knowing that our hearts will only be stronger and only be more beautiful and more loving if we give it nourishment. respite. So in the spirit of balance and that steadiness that comes from the belly, that comes from that center of our body, that point of gravity, I want to share with you and have you join me in a song called Holding My Balance in the Storm. I actually wrote it in 2012. Boy, I wrote some good stuff during Obama. But it was actually a difficult time, and I don't remember, it was a personal time of difficulty, but it's so right for now, when not only do we have fires, but we have hurricanes and floods, and it's just all happening. It's all happening. So in the spirit of balance, here's how this goes. This has got some energy to it, so get ready to move a little bit. I am holding my balance in the storm. Holding my balance in the raging storm. I am holding my balance in the storm. I won't go under, I won't go under. I'll still be standing when the storm is gone. It's kind of an affirmation, you know, of like, this is what I'm made of. This is what I'm dealing with, but this is what I'm made of. So if you downloaded the words or got access to the words, it's in there. If not, it's pretty simple. There's a lot of repetition. So just try it with me. I'm kind of slapping my thighs in rhythm. You can do what you like to do. It's all good. Let me get gallery on. I want to look at you all a little bit. Okay, great. Here we go. All right, here we go. I am holding my balance in the storm. Holding my balance in the raging storm. I am holding my balance in the storm. I won't go under, I won't go under. I'll still be standing when the storm is gone. I am crossing the waters in the storm. Crossing the waters in the raging storm. I am crossing the waters in the storm. I won't go under, I won't go under. I'll still be standing when the storm is gone. And I want to stop for a minute because I realize that I want to dedicate this song to the family of Jacob Blake, his father, his mother, his sisters, and to his sister especially, who did the most incredible press conference. And I can't quote her exactly. Her name is Letetra. It's Julia Jackson Jacob Blake Sr., Letetra Widman. She said, I haven't cried. I am numb. I am tired. I am angry. And she talked, as many Black people have been talking about, we've just seen this for way too long, and here we are again. So I sing this in her spirit for that family. I know they are all holding their balance in a terrible, terrible storm. So as we sing about our own personal storms, we can kind of hold all that as well. Thank you. I needed to do that. I am giving my heart up in the storm, meaning releasing it, giving it to this wildness. I am giving my heart up to the storm, giving my heart up to the raging storm. I am giving my heart up to the storm. I won't go under, I won't go under. I'll still be standing when the storm is gone. Finding my power. I am finding my power in the storm. Finding my power in the raging storm. I am finding my power in storm. I won't go under, I won't go under. I'll still be standing when the storm is gone. I will reach out to find you. I will reach out to find you in the storm. Reach out to find you in the raging storm. I will reach out to find you in the storm. I won't go under, I won't go under. I'll still be standing when the storm is gone. holding my balance. No, I got one more. I am singing my heart out in the storm. Let's do it. I am singing my heart out in the storm, singing my heart out in the raging storm. I am singing my heart out in the storm. I won't go under, I won't go under. I'll still be standing when the storm is gone. Holding my balance. I am holding my balance in the storm. Holding my balance in the raging storm. Holding my balance in the storm. I won't go under, I won't go under. I'll still be standing when the storm is gone. Yeah. Frederick Douglass says, let me find this quote. Frederick Douglass says, "It is not light that we need, but fire. It is not the gentle shower, but thunder. We need the storm, the whirlwind, and the earthquake." And we know what he was talking about. And I feel like we are in that. We are in that time now. And like the phoenix, the good old phoenix, we all love the story of the phoenix. It's such a powerful story. That out of vast destruction, the most beautiful can arise. And in fact, the phoenix cannot live without going through that destruction. The myth is that she lives for 500 years. And then some myths say that she actually sets herself on fire because she knows she has to go to ashes to come back. Other stories tell it a little differently, but I kind of like that one. And Shannon Hertz says, "Just as the phoenix rose from the ashes, we too rise, returning from the flames, clothed in nothing but strength, more beautiful than ever before." And Haruki Murakami says, "And once the storm is over," because we say, "I'll still be standing when the storm is gone." First, that's the implication that the storm will end. Good to remember, it's not always storming. "Once the storm is over, you won't remember how you made it through, how you managed to survive. You won't even be sure whether the storm is really over. But one thing is certain, when you come out of the storm, you won't be the same person who walked in. That's what the storm is all about." I don't know about you, but I do feel like I'm in the crucible these last months, and I'm not going to come out the same person, and that's a good thing. That's a good thing. Yeah. So I like to try to reach back a little bit to songs from earlier times in our lives. We've sung some really old folk songs that I love and hope you do too. And I thought tonight, of course, of that incredible James Taylor song, Fire and Rain. Think about for a minute about how old you were when you heard this song, if you remember. He wrote it in 1968. I was 17 years old. And he was a young person who, like young people do, was seeing a lot. He was seeing a lot about the world, about the suffering. The first verse is about a friend who committed suicide. The second was from his time when he had a breakdown, a severe depression, and was hospitalized. And he lived right out near where I lived in Western Massachusetts, and we were close to the same age, so I feel a certain connection to this. And the third verse is about his shattered dreams of his career, where he'd started a band. I think they were called The Flying Machine, and it just didn't work out at all. And as a young person, at any age, but when you're young, those devastations go so deep, you know? And so he channeled something so powerful in this song of just how it is to be vulnerable and see things falling apart all around you. And for those of us that have children right now or grandchildren who are millennial or whatever, that's what's going on for them too. So I'm really grateful for this song, Fire and Rain. And I think it'll feel good to sing it, actually. Hope you got the words there. Maybe you just remember it. Just yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. Better to see me through another day. My body's aching, my time is at hand. I won't make it any other way. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Been walking my mind to an easy time, my back turned towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Well, there's hours of time on the telephone line, talking about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines and pieces on the ground. I've seen fire. I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Thought I'd see you one more time. There's just a few things coming my way this time around. Thought I'd see you, fire and rain.
Hi,
Madge.
Hi, I just wanted to send that song for Margot Selleck, who died on Friday. She was known to the Womamu community very, very much. And here in Ukiah and Inland Valley Chorus, she was one of the founding members. And she has been struggling with cancer for 4 years, but was doing great until about 2 weeks before and just left us on Friday. So I always thought I would see her again.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Madge. Thanks so much. I find that line incredibly poignant and honest, you know, that there are some things that we will lose and we won't get them back. That's just the truth.
Betsy, you sang that really beautifully. Thank you so much.
Oh.
Really beautifully.
Oh, and I'm sure you did too. Did that feel good, kind of going back to that old familiar? I mean, there's such a sweetness from the times that song came out of. I mean, the general historic times, and you know, like someone singing like a Crosby, Nils, and whatever. You know what I mean? Crosby, Stills, Nash. You know, or Joni Mitchell or a Carole King, and those are my songs. You have your own, but it's just beautiful the way a song can take us back to another time. May not have been the best time, but it's different. At least it's a different time.
Well, I can make it your own, and it was beautiful. Thank you.
Oh, bless you. Thank you so much. Yeah. And the other thing I want to say about the tenderness of youth and vulnerability that James Taylor captured so beautifully, and that we all know, I think we all have our memories of those times when we were younger and the world just looked like it had nothing for us. By the time I was 19, I felt like I'd seen it all, done it all, and I just was not hopeful. I'm sorry to say that, but that was how it was. And yet here we all are. Here we are, having survived so much. And I think that's one of the greatest gifts we can give to the younger people coming up, is just tell them to somehow understand that we have felt what they feel. Not the world has not been like this. This is a new world. And yet that there is this deep, deep survival. Was it Albert Camus who says, I found in the midst of winter, I found in myself an invincible spring. Haven't you found that over and over and over? So speaking of young people, I'm going to do a really sweet song for y'all that I wrote for my boy when he was a junior in high school. Now, junior year high school, everybody knows what that's all about, right? 1, 2, 3. College applications, right? Or visits. Oh, it's just a nightmare. So this is a little song to remind us that in the midst of stress, there's always time. Just like Ferdinand the Bull. Remember Ferdinand the Bull? To sit and smell the flowers. Got a nice little chorus you can help me with. I remember way back when I could barely reach my mama's hand. We walked so slow around the block, seeing all there was to see. Baby birds, ladybugs, a funny cloud, a garden slug. Then she'd turn and give me a hug, smile and say these words to me. Let's just sit and smell the flowers. Let's just while away the hours. There's times we have to hurry, and there's things we have to do, but today let's take our time and smell the flowers. So you get what your line is, right? Smell the flowers, can count on that one. And just jump in. Anytime you hear the word smell, just jump in and sing. Let's do that one together. Let's just sit and smell the flowers. Let's just while away the hours. There's times we have to hurry, and there's things we have to do, but today we'll take our time and smell the flowers. All too soon it's high school years, all the pressure, all the fear, college looming up ahead. Will there be a place for me? There's clubs to join, sports to play. It'll look good on my resume. It's a game that everybody plays. But Mama smiles and says to me, you can sit, sing it with me, and smell the flowers. You can while away the hours. This is my part. There's essays to be written, and there's deadlines to be met, but you still can take some time to smell the flowers. Now I don't know where she got this little point of view. I rarely saw her sitting. She was always on the move. But sometimes she would stop and take a breath and close her eyes, as if just for a moment she was resting deep inside and smelling flowers. Now somehow time has swept me up. I'm drinking from that coffee cup. I drive and talk and work too much. I'm grown up, but I don't feel free. They're talking about a new depression, climate change, insurrection. I think we need a new direction. My mama's words come back to me. We can sit, we can sit and smell the flowers. We can while away the hours. It could save our world, save our souls, if we slip out of the stranglehold. Take a little time to sit and smell the flowers. And this is what I do believe. Our children just need room to breathe. So let's take a little time and smell the flowers. So I meant to warn you at the beginning of the evening. I think I'm going to go a little over tonight. Some nights are just like that. And leave as you must, stay if you can. I have a new one. This is my tradition, you know, of writing a new song every week. This one is so much fun. And it's lively. It's lively. So yeah, that's kind of cool too. So it's this quote that I collected years ago. I don't know where it came from. I've always loved it. And I came upon it as I was going through some old papers. And I thought, oh, this is so perfect for right now, and we're going to sing it. So the words are, the original quote is, it's called Credo for Those Who Are Trying to Better the World. I believe that applies to everyone in this room. And the credo is, we the willing, called by the unknown, have been doing the impossible for so long and with so little, that we are qualified to do almost anything with practically nothing. What do you think? Doesn't that sound like your life? Just a little? Okay, so I want to teach this to you. This is so fun. Here we go. I'll do a line, you sing it back. We know how to do this. We the willing, called by the unknown. Everybody. We the willing, called by the unknown, here I go, have been doing the impossible for so long. Ready? Have been doing the impossible for so long. Let's just do those two together. And these words did come to you in the mailing today, in case you want to look at them, but you don't need to. We the willing, called by the unknown, here we go. We the willing, called by the unknown, have been doing the impossible for so long. Got it? Sort of, kind of? All right, here we go. Next one. So long and with so little that we are qualified. Ready? And with so little that we are qualified. Here's the really fun part. To do almost anything with practically nothing. So it goes like this. I gotta do that whole piece together. It's a little hard to break it up. Here we go. Let's see now. I've been doing the impossible for so long. Doing the impossible for so long and with so little that we are qualified to do almost anything with practically nothing. Okay, so try that with me. And with so little. And with so little that we are qualified to do almost anything with practically nothing. I think the last sentence is my favorite one. I always want to kind of pound my fist with practically nothing. How are you doing? I hope this isn't too hard. I hope it's more fun than hard. We the willing, let's just go for it. All right, take aim and sing. Here we go. I'm going to lift it up just a little. We the willing, called by the unknown, have been doing the impossible for so long, and with so little that we are qualified to do almost anything with practically nothing. Good. We the willing, called by the unknown, have been doing the impossible for so long, and with so little that we are qualified to do all, oh, I did that wrong. We are qualified to do almost anything with practically nothing. Let me see, a little guitar might help us out here. We the willing, called by the unknown, have been doing the impossible for so long, and with so little that we are qualified to do almost everything with practically nothing. One more. We the willing, called by the unknown, have been doing the impossible for so long, and with so little that we are qualified to do almost anything with practically nothing. With practically nothing. Practically nothing. Except each other. All right. Wow. Well, that put us through our paces. Somebody put in the chat, I love it. That's great. I do too. I wrote the music yesterday and I've been singing it all day. It gets into you. I'm warning you. All right, my friends. So real quickly, just a little closing and a question for you. If you had a chance to watch, did you have a chance to watch the video that I created for you from last week when I was not here live? I'd love to see your hands. And don't feel bad if you didn't. It's totally fine. My question is, thanks. I'm really glad. My question is, and you just put it in the chat or send me an email. I'm curious about how that format works. I know it's a really lovely video and I really loved making it. It's got great stuff in it. But I'm wondering if... I'm looking about our human online behavior. Do we really sit down and watch a half hour of something when it's not live? I'm not sure I do, quite honestly. I can watch about 10 minutes of something, maybe 15. It's a whole commitment to take a half an hour out of your day and watch something from start to end. Doesn't mean we don't do it, but I understand the commitment it takes. And so I'm curious if you would like me to continue doing that from time to time, but would you like it to be shorter? What would help it make it really user-friendly? That's what I want, how to make it really work for you. Because honestly, I do need to take some weeks off. And I really love sharing some of those archival concert material and videos from around the world, from Kenya and India and all of that. So I am totally happy to make a 15-minute version or whatever works for you. So give me some feedback and we'll see what happens next. All right. So just no big announcements today. You all know that this is a donation-based event and that your donations help me pay my expenses and also keep in touch and keep in communion with several very special women or women's organizations in Kenya, as well as a little school in India and a village in Nepal, all of whom I am sending resource to. They're all really suffering under COVID and just the... as I've said, you take a poverty, base level poverty in these communities, and then you add COVID and no employment and no health care. And it's just, they need everything I can do and we can do. So I thank you from the bottom of my heart for another evening of restoration and renewal. And we have a minute for you all to say closing blessings, maybe two or three people who'd like to just unmute and offer a blessing to the group or something you're taking away from the evening. It's a nice way to end with your voices. You can just unmute, and you can also raise your hand in the participants. I see Amy's got her hand up.
I was just hoping that we could sing one more round of the, it's not I'm Still Standing, but that's how it's held in my head.
Sure.
Before we close.
Thank you, Amy. We will. That's a great idea. We will, for those who can stay. Beautiful. Thanks. Anything you want to say to the group, Amy?
No, not right now.
Okay. Good. You said what you could say. Very good. Amy is the creator of a beautiful meditation mindfulness program, recordings and trainings. Stillquietplace.org, I think, right? Or
.com.
Stillquietplace.com. She's an old colleague and dear friend. So glad you're here. Anyone else like to raise their hand either on the screen? I can't see you all is the problem with on the screen. In the participants column, you can click raise hand down at the bottom. And feel nice to hear your voices. Lynn?
Oh, I can say something.
Yes, I can. Oh, yes, Lynn, please.
Yes. The first song. This first song of Lay It Down,
yeah.
I mean, universally and personally, because I do carry my personal stuff around. And it was like, oh, yeah, I could do that. Mm-hmm. You're right. You know, remind myself of those lyrics. So thank you. Yeah.
Oh, good. Take it in with you in your heart. Yeah. Good. Thanks, Lynn. I'm with you. I know what you mean. Penelope Burton, I'd love to hear your voice. Can you unmute, Penelope?
I can't thank you enough. This has just been such an incredible inspiration. And I just want to share this brief dedication of merit from the tradition of Yongi Mingur. Mm. By the power of this compassionate practice, may all suffering be transformed into peace. May the heart of all beings be open and their wisdom radiate from within.
Yes.
Penelope, could you put that in the chat?
I did already.
Awesome. Thank you.
Beautiful. It's beautiful to share these resources. I'm so glad you did that, Penelope. Just perfect. Nancy.
Vice President Biden, when he opened his acceptance speech, he quoted Ella Baker's "Send light and people will find a way."
Oh, and there's a wonderful song to that, my friends.
Yes.
Wonderful song. We will sing that another night. I've sung it before. We'll sing it. Thank you all so much. I don't want to keep you too long. If you want to hang out and chat afterwards, sometimes we just do that for a while. But let us end with "Holding My Balance in the Storm." We'll do the whole verse. "I'm holding my balance in the storm." And maybe just take a minute and straighten your body, find that posture just as you would if you were standing. I've been in a hurricane or the edge of a hurricane, and you can lean into the wind and it'll hold you up. It's amazing. It's like being on a boat, just finding your balance, rocking, holding my balance. So friends, as we are buffeted around by all that is going on, just know that balance is fluid. It involves motion. It is not rigid. It is always flexing and changing. And that's our survival. That's right. And we'll still be standing when the storm is gone. I am holding my balance in the storm. Holding my balance in the raging storm. I am holding my balance in the storm. I won't go under, I won't go under. I'll still be standing when the storm is gone. I won't go under, we won't go under. We'll still be standing when the storm is gone. Go in peace. Go in power. See you soon. Tell your friends. Bring them on in.